What up, boys and 1% gals? It's Gaz, and welcome to the Warframe video. So, it is good to be back here, where my character will never get deleted just because I'm playing the game innocently, and, you know, just chilling. So, we are going to be going over some heavy speculation with some facts to back it up about the new update, the Call of Tempestari, hopefully, potentially coming out this week. And what that's going to contain is, well, first off, this update will be coming out on PC and console at the same time. I'm not entirely sure about Switch, if they're going to have that at the same update time and all that, but the main ones that I know a lot of people are on, PlayStation and Xbox, those will definitely be getting the update at the same time as PC. And what's going to be in the update is, first off, it will be, for people on console who haven't gotten it yet, it'll be the Corpus Railjack update, Zephyr rework, all that new stuff with the Corpus Railjack. There's also going to be the Sevagoth frames going to be coming out with a new quest that will be for everyone. And there will also be the Void Storms, which are apparently going to be like fissure missions in the Railjack ship. We don't know if there's any more details besides the fact that it will be fissure missions where you can open relics in Railjack. Some additional details would be great if it was like, maybe like you get like double traces in there. We do know for a fact it will not let you open multiple relics at once, which is what I was really hoping for, but that's whatever. Hopefully they can consider that for someday. But yeah, let's go over the proof of why I think that the update will come out this week, which is the week of April 12th, I guess will be Monday, technically, of this week. So my personal prediction is going to be that the update comes out on April 15th, which is a Thursday, and it potentially could come out on April 14th, which is a Wednesday as well. So I'm guessing the 15th, though, and unfortunately I have to work that day, but I'll try to get back home as soon as possible to stream some of that new update with Sevagoth, which I've been excited for a while. All right, so let's go off the first thing here. That is going to be a leaked image from the PlayStation Store. This was actually last week, and it's saying sponsor. It's a sponsored section on the PlayStation Store, and it says Call of Tempestari, Warframe. It's literally got a picture of Sevagoth on the picture, and that is the fact that it's already on the PlayStation Store kind of is saying a lot as far as I'm concerned. As this update is not currently out, we've never even seen this specific image right here. It's a promotional image with Sevagoth on it. So that's one thing that's saying it's definitely like coming close. They said it was going to be in April. They did not give us an exact date. When we go over the rest of the stuff in this video, you maybe will be convinced that it will probably be this week, which would be sweet because, you know, other games ain't holding up as far as I'm concerned. So we need some stuff in our home game, Warframe, to pump it up a little bit. All right, so that's the first thing. A leaked, mistaken image, whatever the heck you want to call this, with that awesome-looking frame Sevagoth on there. Hopefully he's good. Honestly, hope he's good. I have a sneaking suspicion he will not be very good, but, you know, I would love to be wrong. All right, and let's go over the next thing right here, which is going to be a post from the dev themselves, or one of the devs, Danielle. She works on the community team, and she has given us a big dump of information right here about the update. All right, so let's just read this verbatim, and then we'll go over the spot I put in the red box, just which is the most important details here. So this was meant for console people specifically, but someone posted it in my Discord server, so let's go over it. We are well on our way to simultaneously launch Update 30, Call of the Tempestari, on all platforms. The team has been hard at work getting that stuff ready for launch. As we are aware, we shifted up the no hot fix mode on PC, so that means all hands on deck for each platform ready. All right. So here's the important part right here. We do not have a date to share, but expect to hear from us next week with a release window. So we're going to go over some other stuff I know about here later in the video, but they said that release window should be coming out this week, and I have the high suspicion it will be Thursday. We will just get the update, period. In the meantime, I'm here, so let's go over this. This is how you can prepare for the update if you have not done these things before. And this is just kind of like going to be stuff that people have already probably done, but let's just go over it anyway. Some ways you can prepare. You can prepare for the Call of Tempestari quest by having these prerequisites. Complete the Deadlock Protocol quest. That's the quest with Protea. If you complete that one, you will be able to do this quest. You also need to own a Railjack to do this new quest for Sevagoth. That's important. Complete the Rising Tide. You will also be able to purchase a Railjack in the in-game market once the update launches. So yeah, if you guys didn't know this and you're playing on console, on PC, you can now buy Railjacks for plat. I think it's like 400 plat. Let me go check how much it costs, actually. You can buy Railjacks for plat. It's hilarious, but it's you can also do it with Necromex, technically, too. So here's the Railjack right here. 400 plat for a Railjack. You could buy the Railjack bundle here with the crew member slots and the Nautilus Sentinel. But yeah, just 400 plat for a Railjack. There's no actual variants of it. But you click the button, the Railjack is now yours. So yeah, if you want to do that, just hop in there and you'll be able to do the new Sevagoth quest, the Call of Tempestari. Finishing off the post they gave us, you can also prepare your Zephyr build. I'll show you, I had a video on Zephyr like last week where it was like max range and stuff, and honestly I'm still using the exact same build. I think I changed like one mod slot, so I took like off Augur Reach and I put Augur Message in that slot just for a little bit more duration, just so I'm not casting the 3 as much. But honestly, it doesn't matter. The range is mostly used for her second ability to pull enemies in from further away. Keep in mind, the suction range on her tornadoes is not affected by range. That radius, I guess, is like the cast range or something like that. But the range of stat will not affect the suction radius on the tornadoes, guys. That is important to keep in mind. The range will also affect your air shield from your 3, but not too big of a deal. I'm using Spectro Siphon. This is basically Korra 2.0. I still stand by that statement. Where you just camp and blast your tornadoes constantly and give infinite energy with Spectro Siphon. So very good stuff there. A lot of people do like Breach Surge as well for creating the ghosts that do the most damage in the game from those tornadoes. So those are things you should definitely keep in mind. And finishing off the little post thing right here, read through the Corpus Patch. So I guess you could read through the patch notes for the PC update if you want to just keep up to date. Keep in mind a lot of the previous videos of like, oh, this Railjack thing is ridiculous and stuff. A lot of that stuff's been nerfed. So I might make an updated Railjack guide after the nerfs this upcoming week, maybe after the update actually comes out, if they end up nerfing Seeker Volley like they were joking about on the previous dev stream. If they nerf Seeker Volley, that would suck, but it wouldn't be unexpected, honestly, with how they joke around about these things and actually do it. Although they did joke about nerfing Mesa, I never did that, so you know. All right, so that is the two images I have for you, and now here's the inside info I've got for you. We have nothing but the best information on this channel, and my speculation is backed up by facts here, where I know some Warframe partner streamers have been sponsored to play Warframe this week. Yes, they are being paid money to stream Warframe this week, and why would DE pay these people money to play Warframe on a random day of the week? I really feel like there's enough stuff stacking up here that, and especially knowing that they're getting paid to play Warframe this Wednesday or Thursday, that the update will come out this week, guys, because they're being paid to play on a random Wednesday. They don't really do sponsored streams that often for this game. And no, they did not ask me to get sponsored. That's okay, because we're too cool anyway. So yeah, that's the three reasons. The leaked store image with Sevagoth, picture never seen. The update from Danielle that doesn't exactly say it's coming out this week, but they said that there'll be information about this week and how to prepare for it. And then the inside info of knowing people will be sponsored to play the game this week. All right, is that enough information for you? I think it's enough information for me, and I would love to be right here. If I'm wrong, that would be a bummer, but I'd say don't expect it any later than the week after this one. Because they did say it would be out in April, and April is nearly halfway through at this point. And as far as Corpus Liches and stuff, Corpus Liches will not be in this update, guys. That's something you have to keep in mind. Corpus Liches are planned to be the update after this one, like the next big update after this one. We'll be getting those new ephemeras, hopefully some good new Corpus Lich weapons, and things of that nature. So, hopefully you found this video helpful. I'll see you in the next one. 5 videos a week on this channel, Warframe related, and take it easy, guys. Peace.